Welcome to GardenWise Adventures. My name is Malie, and today it's time for another Plant of the Week video. And with these videos, I am concentrating on herbs this year. Now, I live in Utah Zone 6/7. It's beginning of July, and today's video is going to be about yarrow. Now, yarrow has not been one of my very favorite herbs until this year, and I think it's because I didn't realize all the amazing colors they come in and how gorgeous they can be. Now, I do not talk about medicinal uses of herbs during videos like this because I am not an herbologist, I am not a doctor, and I don't want to give out wrong information. Instead, what we talk about is how to grow them, what they look like, and various uses on your property. So let's go look at my yarrow and talk about why I've planted it, what I like about it, and different things you can do to make it easier to grow. So this is my backyard food forest. It's near the end of the day. The lighting is a little bad for taking a video, especially of these bright yellow colors. But I wanted to show you this yarrow. Now, sorry for all the yelling. It is 4th of July and we are having a lot of people celebrating out here, but this is the only time I had to do this video. So I wanted to get it done. Now this yarrow right here is terracotta. It's called terracotta. It's this gorgeous, I guess you would call it a terracotta color. It's kind of hard to see the color in the video right now because the sun is changing it. But if you can see the color right there, it is absolutely gorgeous. Now, all yarrow fades through time. It comes out a stronger color in the beginning when the buds first open. So here's an unopened bud right here. This is the color that it opens up into. And then it changes into this gorgeous yellow color. So you can kind of see the two different colors. They're a little washed out because of the camera here. But they are gorgeous colors. It's a really tall plant. Some yarrows are taller than others. Some are shorter. Let me show you a little bit of a shorter yarrow. Now this right here is a shorter yarrow. It is a newer one. I don't know exactly how tall it's going to get, but I don't think it's going to get as tall as the one in the back. This one was just planted this year and it's a gorgeous red one. This is the paprika yarrow. Absolutely gorgeous red. It fades to a little bit lighter red color and then it fades to white. This one right here I think is called peach flambé. And it's one of my favorite colors. Absolutely gorgeous peach color when it comes out. And then it fades to kind of, I don't even know what you'd call this color. It's kind of a peachy yellow color. And I love all the different colors together. And it's a little bit shorter than the terracotta one. And then we have the pink varieties. This is one of the summer pastels. It's starting to get washed out. It's a little bit, you know, it started its bloom cycle a little bit earlier. You can see the pink there, and then it fades to white. This is one of the oldest yarrows that I have, and this is the size that I normally thought they get. This is about 2 feet tall. And then this is another color. I think this one's called Summer Sunset, but I love, love, love the progression of colors in this one. We not only have regular yarrow, but this is Moonshine Yarrow. It's a little bit of a different cultivar. This one is huge. It's about 8 feet across and it gets around, I'd say, almost 36 inches tall. But this one is a 15-year-old plant. It's never been divided and it has a very, very long bloom cycle. It starts blooming around May and then it'll sporadically bloom all the way till frost. Now, this one is so large, you know, I didn't cut it back to the ground like I do every year. Didn't cut it back last year like I do every year. And it's kind of split open in the middle, but this is such a big plant. I think it would help if I did go in and divide it. This is a seedling off the last plant that I just showed you. It's also the Moonshine Yarrow. And it does flop a little bit, but it's not as open in the center as the one in the back. This one is a 3-year-old plant. And like I said, it's a seedling off of the other plant that I showed you. Now, yarrow has many uses in the landscape. It does need full sun. It doesn't like a lot of water at all, and it can't take really rich soil. It needs a lean soil, soil without a lot of fertilizer in it. And it's extremely drought tolerant, so you don't have to water it very much. Matter of fact, if you water it too much, it will get floppy. It's hardy from zone 4 through 10, so it is easy to grow just about anywhere as long as you don't have shade. Now, I use it in my landscape to bring in pollinators. The pollinators absolutely love it, and these yarrows have brought in so many different kinds of the beneficial insects. And since I've started growing yarrow in my yard, they have brought in so many cute little pollinators and beneficial insects. So I think that is an excellent use for them. I have them planted in my food forest just for that main purpose, is to bring in the beneficials. And they are turning out to be an excellent cut flower. Now, I don't normally cut flowers and bring them into my house because I don't have the kind of time and energy it takes to constantly switch out water. But I have a bouquet in my house that has been there for about 2 weeks and it's just barely starting to fade. So they make great cut flowers. You can dry them and put them in arrangements. Like I said at the beginning of this video, they are medicinal. If you're going to use them for medicinal purposes, definitely find somebody who knows what they're talking about. So I'd love to hear if you've been growing yarrow, where you're located, and if it grows well in your area. So hopefully this video has been helpful for you. If it has been helpful, I hope you like, subscribe, share it with your friends, and go have a wonderful day.